Then when you discretize in time, that is, you know, implicit or explicit or possibly some mixed method, what you get ought to look familiar. It's just the same exact equation. 1 over delta t times b. Plus q. So this is exactly like before. So if you can't read that, it's just exactly as in 1D. So it's the same exact equation as we got in 1D. It's just the main difference is the form of the matrices themselves. Right? So then the last thing is, of course, just like before, we have these minus 1/2 terms and we have to deal with somehow. And those come in through the application of boundary conditions. And so when we apply the boundary conditions, just like before, if we have, say, t to the minus 1/2, 0, this would indicate that somehow on the left side of our t to the minus 1/2 in any value of j, right, would indicate that there's some kind of boundary condition on the left side of our domain. And so if it's a constant pressure boundary condition, so if, or what we call prescribed pressure, then t to the minus 1/2 j is just going to become 2t I guess I'll say 0 j, and then the q vector at that location, the q vector at the corresponding location would have a 2t 0 j PB. All right, so in this case, if you had some reservoir that looked like this, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, then our Q vector is in the 0, 2, 4, and 6 locations going to have T0J, let's say, now, it'll be 0, PB, 0, 2, 0, 1, PB, 0, 2, 0, 2, PB, 0, 2, 0, 3, PB. Right, so these correspond, of course, to the L equals 0, L equals 2, L equals 4, and L equals 6 grid block numbers. So those correspond to those grid block numbers where there's a constant pressure boundary condition, right? Likewise, if there's no flux, so then T let's say in this case it's a nx minus 1/2 j. So anything along this boundary here, if it's no flow, just like before, will be 0. Right? So that's how you handle the boundary conditions.